You're asked to solve this by completing the square. The first step is to add the constant term to the other side. X squared minus x equals 6. Now let's leave some space for the special number that's going to complete the square. Since the leading coefficient is 1, I'm going to look at the coefficient on the x term, minus x. So that really tells me the coefficient is negative 1. You want to take that coefficient, divide it by 2, and then square it. So negative 1/2 squared is positive 1/4. So to make this a perfect square, I'm going to add 1/4 to both sides. Okay, when I do that, factoring this, I get x and x. 1/4 factors into 1/2 times 1/2. 1/2 and 1/2 adds up to negative 1 if they're both negative, and then a negative times a negative is positive 1/4. Now on the right side, 6 plus 1/4 is 25/4. 6 over 1 plus 1 over 4. To go off to the side and do those. Leaving me with x minus 1/2 squared equals 25/4. Okay, I've isolated the square. Now we're ready to extract the root. Take the square root of both sides. Don't forget, plus or minus when you do that. Leaves us with x minus 1/2 equals plus or minus 5/2. Square root of 25 is 5, square root of 4 is 2. Adding 1/2 to both sides, that'll equal 1/2 plus or minus 5/2. Okay, so x equals 1/2 minus 5/2, or x equals 1/2 plus 5/2. We're lucky to have a common denominator already, so this is equal to negative 4/2 or negative 2. And this one gives us 6/2 or 3. Okay, so our two solutions here are going to be negative 2 and 3. And you can go back to the original here, plug them in, see if they work.